Hello YouTube and welcome. We are here day number two at the Monroeville Demolition Derby. There was a good show, good turnout yesterday, and there is a great turnout today. This is probably actually, of the derbies I've filmed, has one of the better turnouts. I mean, there is a lot of vehicles here. I am very surprised. There's still some more coming through inspections. Tonight, the events you guys will be seeing, we will be having the compact demolition derby, which will be a lot of the people from yesterday returning and a couple new people. Also, we will be having a bone stock class for full size, and then we will also be having a modified class for full size, and we will be having a pickup truck derby also. So stay tuned to that. We have four different heats going on, four different events, I mean. I'll give you guys a walkthrough here in the beginning, catch up here. This lineup right here by me is the bone stock cars. Some of these did run at Hoagland if they're pre-ran. And this row right here on back is all modifieds. And yes, you can load your bumpers here. Almost all these cars have solid steel bumpers that have been loaded. As you can see, the stock class doesn't have headers coming out of the hoods. That's part of their rules. Must have the bumpers that came with the car mounted on them. Can't do really much at all to these cars but wire them down. You are allowed using mud tires though, that does help.
Job, so that's when this deal, I bought this motor for $500. I mean, the deal of a lifetime came around with
the... You can see the bumper on this one's been homemade. It's got a heck of a homemade pointy. It's just solid steel plating all the way through.
That's for the tri-axis pieces.
This is a 70s LeSabre for his bone stock. This looks like a Cadillac, I believe, from the 90s or late 80s. This is a 90s Caprice, and the back tire is going flat right now as we speak. That kind of sucks. This car has been taking some hits before, as you can see. It's bent pretty good. Surprising, actually, this car has steel inner fenders, as new as it is. You don't see that at all with too many newer cars. Hey Kyle, what's up, man? Good to see you here.
Take her out.
Looking good.
You're here for a good show tonight. Still have a tough truck left from yesterday sitting over there. Stuck in gear, they can't start it. It's a girl driving this car, surprisingly. This is a late, this is like a 79 Impala, I believe. Something like that. Something real close to it. This will be an interesting car to see run in the stock class. I have not seen too many of these kind of cars run, actually. Kind of curious how the trunk does on it. They kind of half tucked it. You're not allowed to actually put the trunk lid down inside the trunk, so I just cut half of it off and wired it in place. Help it pack in better. And there's still some compact over there, another compact there, and several others. So there are more coming. Pretty sure that truck actually might be leaving. I don't think they passed inspections. Another truck getting ready to change some stuff. Look, those guys are trying to find out how to get out of here. Yeah, their truck, front suspension was set too high, I believe. At least that was one of the things. They could not pass the bumper height rules. That was welded solid. Unless they're gonna go bring it somewhere and change it, then maybe they'll come back. We'll see. And that car right there ran yesterday in the bone stock class with the battery and gas tank still in the car, stock from there. And here comes another car getting through inspections at the end. That's just about all of them for over here. Let's head over this way and check out the trucks and compacts before we're done with our little prelude. This truck is seen a lot better days. This thing is taking some serious abuse. That front bumper is just destroyed and bent on an angle. Anything that hits the front of this truck is going to ramp. They're going to hit that bumper, they're going to ramp up it and just trash the front end on it. That radiator will not last long. And this rear frame, it's shot too. It's bending real hard in the back. It's a pretty steep angle on it. Here's a fresh truck for the Derby. This truck, it looks like something pretty new. I can't tell the exact year. I'm gonna say maybe 90s style of truck. But you are allowed to load your bumpers for this class also. And if you look at the front bumper, it's actually a railroad track bumper. It's just a big piece off of a railroad that they welded to the front frame and covered it with a chrome skin. Because the rules here say you can put anything you want in your bumper as long as it looks like a bumper on the outside. So that's what they did. That bumper still has the factory chrome cover off of trucks, but they put steel plate behind the whole thing, bolted it on. I'm imagining this truck right here and that truck over there are both on a team, hence the name and the orange color. This is a newer truck as well, late 80s, early 90s. Another car coming through there, looks like for the modified class. And up here is the compacts, which always has a great car count every year at this Derby. This wagon ran yesterday, and this is the one that was actually shooting flames out from underneath it at the very start of the Derby. If you go back and watch that video, there is something messed up with the engine to where it's burning so much fuel, it's actually shooting fire out of the exhaust under the car whenever it runs. And there's the Mustang back, ready for round two. It had some problems, overheated way early on last derby. Car is perfectly fine. We're on today. There's Brandon Reimer kicking it with his Camaro, ready for day number two. See how long it could survive, having some transmission issues today. This car ran yesterday, had stupid problems happen early on, took two hits, fresh car. His green one actually won in the figure eight yesterday. This car has been used for a figure eight car for at least a year now, if not more. Now it's finally getting retired and going to be turned into a derby car. So it'll get tracked tonight. This number 23 ran in figure eight yesterday. Now it's here for the derby today. There's a car that took third place yesterday. Ended up getting stuck against the wall with Brandon's car. The front strut got laid over pretty hard on the front passenger side, but they fixed that, put a new strut in it overnight, and the car is good to go again. This car ran figure eight and then tried to run in the compacts, but didn't last long. Something broke up front. They fixed it, brought it back today. That guy has a front tire starting to go flat. Oh yeah. This is the car right here that took third place yesterday in compacts. It's back for more. That is a 80s Thunderbird. Definitely an interesting car. I've not seen any of them run before until now. They're actually pretty strong cars. I was very surprised. That car does not have any type of back end left to it. It's pushed in into the back seat. Wow, he's got to go forwards the whole time. There's nothing to use on the back. And there's another one heading in for mods. There's a few more trucks coming through and one more full size right there. And we're good to go. Have it. There's the lineup. Day number two for the Prelude. Stay tuned for all the videos of the Derby.